Various groups converged at Daliwasang Bonifacio, one of Manila's freedom parks, to commemorate the 49th anniversary of the Declaration of Martial Law. But it did not come without challenges, as authorities used water cannons against some protesters while trying to reach the venue. Meantime, some martial law survivors recalled how they were tortured by security forces of the Marcos regime. Nilda was a 19-year-old college student when she was forcibly taken and sexually harassed by her abductors.
Pinababa nila yung part ng para lumabas yung tigi ko. Yung tigi. So, yun. So, siyempre umiyak na ako noon. Kasi isip ko, baka ang kasunod nito ay papasokin na isang kwarto ulit tapos rewrite na ako.
She says the trauma lingers on almost 5 decades since martial law was imposed by former President Ferdinand Marcos on September 21, 1972.
Yung torture, mental and physical yun. Pero ang malalim yung mental. Kasi kahit hanggang ngayon, hanggang hindi pa rin ako comfortable sa mga kampo, sa mga naka-uniform na military.
With the Marcoses back in power and the 2022 elections approaching, activists are doubling their efforts against historical revisionism as they try to dispel misinformation that Filipinos were better off during martial rule.
Noong mga panahon na yon, habang kami ay nag-oorganisa, sa hanay ng mga manggagawa, hindi ang galit ng mga manggagawa sapagkat napakababa ng sahod, napakababa ng sweldo ng manggagawa, walang karapatang mag-union, sinusupil ang kanilang karapatan.
Historian Xiao Chua explains one of the reasons why false information surrounding the martial law years persist is because the Marcoses themselves have been able to stay in power.
Because they cannot escape their father, although they wanted to really stand on their own achievements, they cannot escape the legacy of their father, and that's why they have to cleanse the memory of their father, which is sad because they should have just acknowledged that there were bad things that happened during his administration.
Human rights lawyer Chel Jocno says videos aimed at distorting the perception of the youth on martial law have been around since the early 2000s, enough reason to continue educating them of the atrocities perpetrated by the Marcos administration.
Today that we are commemorating the declaration of martial law, I just want to share something I learned from my father. If we really want to build a just and humane Philippines, we need to have a national consciousness and a national conscience. At sana sa darating na taon na mabibigyan tayong lahat ng pagkakataon na pumili ng susunod na liderato, ay pumili naman tayo ng mga kandidatong may national consciousness at lalo na may national conscience.
Vice President Lenny Robredo said in a Facebook message that she shares the sentiments of anti-Marcos forces as the fight against dictatorial rule continues.
Kailangan nating ulit-ulitin sa bawat pagkakataon ang katotohanan. Sa ilalim ng rehimeng Marcos, nagdusa ang Pilipino. Ninakawan, tinorture at pinaslang. Ginamit ang ngalan para ibaon ang bansa sa utang at pagbabayaran ng utang na ito hanggang sa mga susunod pang henerasyon.
Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.